Good evening, world. Welcome to Club Isolation, the place where God separates you from all of mankind and forces you to do the shadow work, the inner healing, and basically just makes you get in touch with yourself, who you are, who He's chosen you to be. It's lonely, but it's invigorating, it's inspiring, and I know ultimately it's helping me become the best version of myself. Sunday, September 3rd, will be 11 months that I will have been drug-free. You know I'm my biggest cheerleader because I have no one else to cheer for me. Coming up on a year, I did not think I would make it this far, but through God's grace and mercy, I have. And so that's something to be proud of, which leads me to the video today. Someone actually left a comment on a comment that I had left 9 months ago. And she basically asked me, had my breakthrough come through yet? So what I want to do is read it to you just to show you what my response was. And this song has been my inspiration today. I'm Still Standing by Elton John, because I'm still standing. There was a YouTuber, she had made a video, a post, and it was, the topic was, your habits will make you or break you. And my response was, wow. I'm currently writing my manifestations and affirmations right now. Just got up off of these 43-year-old knees praying to God, my ancestors, angels and spirit guides, source in the universe. Just kicked my alcohol, drug, and cigarette addiction. I'm currently homeless because after I had a spiritual awakening, everyone abandoned me. I had to change. It's the loneliest I've ever been, but it's also the healthiest I've ever been. My breakthrough is near. This I know for sure. And that was 9 months ago. And so the young lady who left me a comment yesterday, she said, did your breakthrough come through yet? And I didn't respond yesterday because I was in my feelings yesterday. I was broke, I was hungry, and honestly, because my breakthrough hasn't come through in the way that I feel like it should have. So I was hesitant to respond, but today I know that I have to engage with anyone who reaches out to me, because that's a blessing. I talk about being lonely, so when somebody wants to communicate with me, it's like, take that opportunity. Somebody's communicating with you, talk to them, you know, even if y'all may not understand each other, whatever, just seize the opportunity to just simply communicate with another person. So I responded today, and this is what I said. I said, good morning. In the physical sense, I can honestly say that no, I have not received a breakthrough yet. I'm still currently unemployed and homeless. However, I am yet alive, and this Sunday marks 11 months that I have been completely drug-free and over 2 years alcohol-free. In this isolation period, I have learned so much about myself, how to be more compassionate and considerate to others, how to eliminate toxic people, places, and things out of my life, how to love unconditionally, and spread slash show that love to those who need it most. I have discovered that my purpose lies. I have discovered that my purpose lies in being of service to others, even with my limited resources. Helping someone doesn't necessarily require monetary deeds, a simple good morning or a hug, listening to someone's problems, Holding the door for the elderly or offering to help with carrying their bags are ways in which I can still give unto others while still waiting on my financial blessing in order for me to help others, in order to help the world on a much larger scale. Because that's what I truly believe is my calling and gift, philanthropy, giving back. It's the only thing that completes me and fulfills me. So I guess after writing all of that, perhaps I have received my breakthrough. It just may not have been in the way that I envisioned it for myself. God is continuously working on me and helping me to discover more and more about myself and helping me to become the best version of myself each and every day. And because I am being obedient and listening to the direction of God, I am confident that He will eventually relocate me to the land of milk and honey. Peace and blessings. But God's not through with me by a long shot. I know there are great things in me and even greater things to come out of me. Amen. And that was my response. And it's just like, wow. Sometimes, because I know that I have the gift of writing, I didn't know what I was going to say to her when I started responding back. I just was speaking from the heart. And after I completed the message and I read it back and proofread it before sending it, I was like, listen at yourself, Desmond. You really have come a long way. You have received a breakthrough. To be off of drugs and alcohol, that's a miracle in itself. When you've been abusing and using for over 20 plus years, your entire adult life, that's your breakthrough. And even right now, in this moment, I'm just getting confirmation, my aha moment, that I just literally said in that message that giving back doesn't necessarily mean monetary deeds. So God has given back to me so much more than just financial reward. He's given me back my life, my health, my mental stability. My mental vision is clear. It's no longer cloudy by drugs and alcohol. He's done great things for me. He's doing great things for me. I have to humble myself so much and be grateful and thankful for what I do have. I spoke the other day when I made a video and I spoke about how I saw a mouse in my room and it terrified me and it made me unhappy and uncomfortable and I hate being here, but I would hate being on the streets so much more. I still have a bed. I still have a roof over my head and hot water. I have some things to eat. You know, life could be so much worse. I have to be appreciative of what I do have. I have my life. I'm sober. I'm clean. I'm smiling. Now, some days you'll see my videos and you'll see me boohoo crying. But today I'm smiling. Her reaching out to me was a way of me to get back in touch with myself and get back to the basics and for me to realize how blessed I truly am. How grateful I truly am to see the great things that God has done for me, how He has blessed me and showed me grace and mercy and favor. And like I said, it may not have been in the way that I want, because I want abundance, prosperity, generational wealth. I want a house of my own. I want a car. I want a profession that allows me to give back to the world, philanthropy. Oh, that's another one. I looked up the word philanthropy because I posted in another video, like, that's what my calling is. It's the only thing that completes me. I even said it in the message. And I know that's what I'm supposed to do with my life, is to give back. And if you can see this, you notice that I always do the little heart sign with my hands. And that's what came up under philanthropy. But the definition of philanthropy was... philanthropy is really a mindset where you care so deeply for humankind that you will spend your time, energy, superpowers, and or resources to create a sincere impact on humanity. Philanthropy is about wanting to make an impact on the greater good. That's me. That's all I know. That's all I know how to do is to help others and to give back. And that's what I'm going to make my mission. And so if nobody's told you today that they love you, God loves you. And so do I. Y'all have a blessed evening. Peace.